So example 3, we're having x squared plus 4x plus 3 is equals to 0. So for factorization, so if you multiply 3 multiplied by x squared, so this 3 multiplied by x squared, we are having 3x squared. So the two numbers whereby when we multiply it, it will give us 3x squared, and when we add it, it will give us 4x, is x and 3x. When we multiply it, x plus 3x, it will give us 4x. I mean, when we add it rather, x plus 3x will give us 4x. If you should multiply x multiplied by 3x, it will give us 3x squared. So you are going to replace it with 4x. So our equation will now be x squared plus x plus 3x plus 3 equals to 0. So now let's bracket in 2. So for the first bracket, we bring out, we look for a value that is similar to the two value inside the bracket. So the number here is x. X is common. So if you have x, so x squared divided by x, you'll be left with x. So x divided by x, you'll be left with plus 1. And right here, if you look at what's common here, is 3. So plus 3. So 3x divided by 3, we have x. 3 divided by 3, so we are going to be having plus 1. So now that we're having the same value, x plus 1 in the bracket, that gives us an idea that we are still correct. So now we bring these two together, x plus 3. So x plus 3, then pick one of the x plus 1 equals to 0. So now let's equate the two of them into to 0. So we are going to be having x plus 3 equals to 0 and x plus 1 equals to 0. So if 3 should come to the other side of the equation so that x can stand alone, so because we are looking for x, so our x is equals to minus 3. So if minus 1 should come to the other side of the equation, our x is equals to minus 1. So this is the value of x for the equation x squared, for the quadratic equation x squared plus 4x plus 3.